So this is my Hover Things Flip FPV 260, which is in all but name a mini series, and it is minute. I've no idea how I'm going to squeeze all the electronics and cameras and bits and pieces on there. I've started doing it and I've seen people do cram enough on there. So this is where I'm at the moment. It's going to run on. I'll go through some of the bits while you can actually see it. That's my theory behind this, because once it's closed up, you will not see a thing. It's all going to be very tight. I had initially started doing this and my intention was to make it kind of a cheap one. One I can throw into places which I wouldn't normally put a quadcopter. And just kind of throw it around a bit more. I've got the other Hover Things Flip FPV, I think it's a 360 size, something like that. And it's not a bad frame, it's not broken yet, so that's good. Has to be good. This one, like I say, because I wanted to keep the price down and the weight, I'm not that bothered about the weight at the moment. We'll see how it goes later on. I may want to shed a bit of weight. I'm going for the tube option, and this is the Copter Control 3D by Lumineer, something like that. It's a Lumineer edition anyway. And comes with all the cables necessary. I've already got him installed on the bottom frame. And hopefully I can squeeze a few more bits and pieces in there. This one, I think it's a better quality one. I have got somewhere, came from China. That is the equivalent, Copter Control 3D, China version. These are meant to be quite, not this specific one, but these Copter Control 3Ds are supposed to be quite good now. And because I've had quite a bit of success with my KK2 boards, I thought I'd go away from the NASA and give these cheaper options a go. Lightweight, not much to them, no GPS. I think there's loads of add-ons you can get for these, but I'm just going to keep this one as simple as I possibly can. So I do have a spare one, which will be going on a 3D printed mini of some kind, or a quadcopter. I'm just going to do a comparison between the... I think that was twice the price. The Lumineer one was twice the price of this China import. So we'll see whether it's worth it or not. So with this version, you get all the wires to the servo leads, whereas on the cheaper Chinese version, I'm going to have to fabricate something. You come with the connector to the board, and that's it. All these have to go to the servo-type connectors somehow. So that's going to involve a bit more work, unless I can find somewhere where I can just buy one of these with them all soldered up already. I'll find out later on. It doesn't matter for now. So this is, is that the middle plate? Yeah, that's a middle plate. Let me sort some of this out. I've got gear everywhere. So it is going to be based on a 3-cell battery. I'm going to use a 3-cell 1500, 1800, something around that region, just because I've got them already. So, and I think that's kind of an optimum size people seem to be running them on. Let me have a look. The motors, I've got a couple of options with that. This is the actual bottom board. Let me sort it out a bit. It's going to run on these 12 amp 3-2, I think it's 6-cell, 3-6-cell ESCs. They were recommended with the to run on this. Mantis, the make, never heard of them. Flash with the Simon K firmware. And those are married up to some very nice looking Tiger motors. These are a 2300 kilovolt, and they are minute. I like the Tiger motors. I have to say that everything I've got a Tiger motor on, the balancing of them is just, you can just tell the quality of them, totally different. So as regards keeping this a cheap build, and then I go and purchase some Tiger motors to go on there. I do have, let me have a look. These are going to spin a 5-inch prop. I think that's 5x4. They look cheap and nasty, but because they're so small, oh, and bendy. Oh, dear me. Again, these just came off the Hover Things site. I think it's in the Dutch site anyway. They do look bendy. We'll see how they go. I think it can spin a 6-inch prop if necessary, but he's 5-inch optimum size, and because they're so small, you're not going to get much vibration in theory, so it doesn't matter that they are cheap and bendy. So we'll see how those go as well. They'd better go well because I've got a whole shed load of them in there. Also, the motors, another option I had. These are something that are recommended from the Hover Things site. These are some Cobra motors, 2204. Again, these are 2300 kilovolts, and I cannot get that out the box to save my life. There we go. There you go, a nice little natty motor. Slightly larger, but a bigger pancake to it. But I may give those a spin. I think these were cheaper, but I got the Tigers as well as backup. So these are meant to be quite good. I've got to say the Cobras meant to be a nice version. These are the newer versions of them, and the problem with these things are everything's small. All the screw sizes go down to like an M2 screw size. Fixing the motors down, so whether that holds up or not. I've Loctited all of these motors down already, so that's how I'm worried about them. I am, and they're all Loctited down. Again, it's all soldered up this time. I've gone with no bullet connectors whatsoever. I could probably easily shorten these leads down from the ESC to the motor, but at the moment, I'm not sure on how I'm going to wire it up. That's been stalling the build while I wait for a distribution board to make all of this work. I was going to do a wiring loom like I had done before, but I'm not keen on the wiring loom. I hate making them, and they tend to be the failure point. They're very fiddly to put together, especially larger gauge wire. I guess a smaller gauge like these ones would be easier, but I've gone with, let me find it, a power distribution board, which allows you, because I intend to also pull the power off for my FPV equipment. I'm going to pull the power off to the camera and the video transmitter from here, and I've got somewhere at the moment, I can't find it, so I am somehow going to have to squeeze that in on that deck. I've got a plan of action with that. It converts the 12 volt down to 5 volt for your video camera if necessary. And you've got a few more options with it. It's just a more fancy Dan distribution board. I was going to use this one. This was just your basic generic distribution board. I've used those before. They're okay in some circumstances, but I've gone with this more high-tech one. Wasn't expensive, I don't think. I think that's why I went with this one in the end. It was a UK-based company as well, just selling them. Seemed to take forever. It took about a week and so to arrive, so it just came today. So that's been holding the build up, so I can get on with it now. I'm a little bit disappointed with the size of this. I was hoping it was, I think that's about 50 by 50 or 40 by 40 millimeters. It's just slightly oversized if you look in comparison to the CC board. I was hoping to fit it underneath so it'd be a similar size, but size comparison is way off. So again, I'm gonna have to do something fancy with the build. I've put this together, but I know I'm gonna have to undo all that and put it together properly. I need to probably reorientate it anyway when I find out which way the motors are turning. I've wired all the ESCs up so that I've got two opposite wiring looms, if that makes sense. So I've got the two diagonals wired up one certain way and these two diagonals wired up a certain way, so when I come to do the motor check, when I've got this thing in, if two are spinning the wrong way, it's going to be the equal two in theory, so I can just spin the actual board round, or I can actually just spin that round because it's not even on yet, so that makes it even easier. So I can just spin the whole frame round and make the front the back, the back the front. That's the theory anyway. So that I'm going to put in there and maybe use some spacers, or I can make some. One of the options I've got for the ESCs are these 12 amp Afro ESC, Salmon K flashed, and they are meant to be pretty good. A lot of people seem to be using these for the multicopters, especially the smaller ones, obviously with the 12 amp rating. So I'll have to have a check on these. This is just a fallback option if those are no good. I'll have to check the frequency of those other ones. I'm not exactly sure what they are. So again, these are really lightweight, all small. Those actually have bullet connectors on, so I'd have to strip those out and do some soldering. But yeah, I've got five of those. I pulled. Yep, it was by a spare. So I've got five of those Afro ESCs that will be going on either this quad mini or my own homebrew. That's kind of why I've doubled up on a lot of things, because I intend to make a 3D printed one at some point. If I don't destroy this in the meantime, then I will make a 3D printed one with these bits. If not, these bits will wing their way onto that little flip hover things mini quad. So that's sort of how it's going to go. And like I say, you can see why it's going to be a bit of a nightmare squeezing everything in. So that would be the bottom deck. I'll just get that out of the way. And then that would be the middle deck. And then, oh, what have I got on there as well? I've got, this is the FPV camera that I'm going with. These are really cheap. I have no idea if they're any good or not. They are a Sony 600. Let's see how they go. I've got three of them, so they better be good. But it's just a cheaper option compared to the TBS ones that I'd had. That's kind of in keeping with me trying to keep the cost of this thing down. So if it does drop in the water, or I do lose it in a tree, or it goes a little bit wild, and the loss isn't so great on my wallet, my ever-decreasing size of wallet. So that's that one. That hopefully goes, it comes with a frame, but again, it comes with gear, but you still have to make it work. It needs some kind of standoffs of some kind, and then it will. You got a few options actually as to where you position this so the lens doesn't stick out. So yeah, quite like that. Quite nice little frame for as tight as compact as it is. It's got options there. It's got lots of things you can kind of lots of slots and holes to put things through and tie things on and bolt things on. So that's that one, and then finally, that's the top deck, or the battery tray, will go on there. And that, in theory, is how it's going to look, with a few more bits hanging off, no doubt. I've got, let me have a look, for the top deck, I've got a cheapo Mobius camera. I would like to have had the GoPro on, but this is, you know, I don't know, the weight-wise, it feels a lot lighter than a GoPro. A lot more streamlined as well, and quite easy to put some kind of tray. I think Cover Things now do a clean deck tray, which is pretty much a vibration-proofed tray that sits on the top with a few kind of isolation balls on there. But I reckon I can I've got some spare isolation dampers, so I'm pretty sure I can easily make those work on there. So that's where the Mobius is going to sit. Battery on there. Oh, there's one. Let me try that. I'm not sure what size people are running, but here we go. That's going to be a 1800 milliamp 3 cell. Oh, it's getting busy on there. It is getting busy. And what else have I got to somehow fit on there? This is an immersion RC 600 milliwatt video transmitter. And I think I can squeeze that in. I think that's going to go on the lower tray on the back. Somehow there. Again, I can easily knock something up myself on my printer for that. Let me see. So I'm going to squeeze that in. The good thing about these Immersion RC ones is it will control the output to your video camera, or the voltage to your video camera. So hopefully, I've got a couple of options there for the powering of the video camera. I think, that's something I have to check this, I can't even remember if this, I think it's a 12 volt video camera. I'm not 100% sure, I'll have to go check the stats on that again. I'm pretty sure it is a 12 volt, nothing on there to say otherwise. No, don't know. That's something I'll have to check. It'll be easy enough to sort out either way, especially with that new distribution board. And I'm going to use it, run it from one of my basic Futabas. Not long range. I'm going to keep this. I'm not sure what they're good for distance wise, but I've never had much trouble with them. It's slightly big, this, for a small multi-rotor like this one, but that'll do. I might strip this down later on, take the cover off. I'm not sure. Again, not that worried about the weight. So somehow squeeze that on there. That'd be good if you could just do that. And a Fat Shark aerial. I think I've got a better one than that. This is a three-lobe clove leaf, I think. I've had poor reception with this one. Not poor, it just seems to break up a little bit more. It makes you a little bit nervous when flying with this one on. And I'm pretty sure that's because it is a three-leaf clover and it doesn't really work in my setup so well. So we'll see how that goes, but that also has to go on there. And that's about it. Seems easy, but I think it'll work, especially with that distribution board. No idea what the weight's going to be. Ooh, you see, that feels quite heavy. So for someone like me who doesn't really care about the weight, I am a little bit concerned about the weight. I've got smaller batteries, I've got to say. That's all right. That'll fly, right? Everything flies with these new controller boards on. Be interesting to see how the Copter Control 3D board goes. And I'm going to get it built and let's go put it up in the air.